Hello, and welcome again to our Windows 7, Beginner to Advanced video training series. In the fifth part of our Wordpad series, today we will learn about insert options of Wordpad. Then we will talk about other commands like strikethrough, show hide options, word wrap, and page orientation. First, let's see how you can use strikethrough command in your documents. The purpose of the strikethrough is to draw a line through the text. For instance, I select a line from my document, and then I click on strikethrough button. You can see a line in the middle of the text. But what could be the use of this? Here, I give you a demonstration, so you can understand the concept of using strikethrough. Suppose, I want to prepare a sale pamphlet for a new offer to the customers, where I want to describe that the price has been reduced from $15 to $10. Let's open a new document first and prepare our offer. After completing the formatting of this pamphlet, here how I will apply strikethrough on this pamphlet. Here, I am mentioning that, before the sale offer, the price was $15, but now you can get the same item in $10. But I don't want to get the customer confused with both prices on the pamphlet. I can draw a straight line on $15, using the strikethrough command. So, here we have a final price for customers, which is $10. But they are also aware that the older prices was $15. To make this pamphlet more attractive, you can place a picture of the jacket at the bottom of the page. To insert a picture, click on the Insert Picture icon, and move to the folder where your pictures are stored. Here I have two files in my picture folder, Jacket 1 and Jacket 2, but I want to view the files before I insert them. You can change the view style of your folders by clicking on More Options drop-down menu under Change Your View. Here, I choose Large Icons, so I can have a preview of the pictures. After this, choose the picture that you want to insert and click Open button. To change the size of the picture, select the picture and drag the sizing handles in or out to increase or decrease the picture size. Let's have a preview of our document. In preview window, you can see that our document has been extended on two pages. So, I reduce the size of the picture, so it gets adjusted on the first page. In Wordpad, you don't have enough options to move the pictures. You can only have your pictures in the left, center, or right side of the page. Or you can manually adjust the picture by having some spaces or tab in front of the picture. You cannot type anything in the picture area. Left or right side empty areas cannot be used to type text. Your text will only wrap on the top and bottom side of the picture. If later you decide to change your current picture, then you don't have to delete and insert a new one. Instead of doing this, you can select the picture and then click on Change Picture. Select the new picture you wish as replacement for the current, and click Open. By this way, you don't have to adjust the positions and sizes again. You can also resize a picture using Resize Picture option. Here you have to define the size in %age. Here, we have another option, Lock Aspect Ratio, which is checked by default. The lock aspect ratio as this option is checked, so Wordpad will try to maintain the height and the width ratio of the picture. That means, if you change the width of the picture, Then the height will be automatically adjusted by the WordPad, and the picture will not get stretched. If you uncheck this option, then you can define different height and width for the picture. You can make your documents more attractive by inserting your paintbrush drawings into WordPad. What you have to do is to click on Paint Drawing button. And this will open another window of paintbrush. Now, draw whatever you want, and after finishing your drawing, just close the paintbrush, and your drawing will be in your WordPad document. This is a nice feature of WordPad, because you can accomplish those tasks which are not possible through WordPad. For instance, as I am creating a sale logo, you cannot fill double colors in WordPad. We will discuss paintbrush detail in our upcoming videos. You can quickly insert a date and time stamp into your document. Click the date and time button from the insert section, and choose a suitable style. You can also insert objects from other applications, which are installed on your system. Like, I want to have a graph inside my current document. To accomplish this, I click on Insert Object button. From Object Type List, I choose Microsoft Excel Chart, and click OK button. This will open another window of Microsoft Excel. Here you will see a predefined chart. You can click on Sheet 1 to change the value. And those value will immediately take effect on the chart. After finishing entering values, close the Excel, and the graph will automatically get inserted in your document. You can delete a picture or object by selecting the picture or object and press Delete button from keyboard. You can even have your object display as icon. While inserting an object, make a check mark on Display as icon. So instead of displaying the contents of the object, an icon will appear in your document. You can modify the contents by double-clicking on the icon. Even you can insert already saved documents as an object in your current document. Click Insert Object, then click Create from a file and browse for your document that you want to insert. You can turn off ruler and status bar from view menu. But do remember that, if you turn off ruler, then you have to define indents and tabs, using paragraph options. And you have to zoom in or zoom out your document, through zoom options in view menu, or using Ctrl plus scroll button of your mouse, because zoom slider will no longer be available. You can place your favorite, or most useful command in quick access toolbar. Click the drop-down arrow in the Quick Access toolbar, and make a check mark on the commands that you want to have in your toolbar. Like, I make a check mark on the Print Preview button. So, I don't have to click on WordPad menu, then Print, and the Print Preview, to see the preview of my file. You can also change the position of Quick Access toolbar by clicking on Show Below the Ribbon, or Show Above the Ribbon. You can minimize the WordPad ribbon by clicking on Minimize the Ribbon. This will hide the menu bar and will increase the space on your screen. But you have to click every time on Home or View menu to access the commands. You can either uncheck the Minimize the Ribbon or double-click on Home or View menu to fix them on screen. As you can see, now I have a document on the screen, consisting of two long paragraphs. Let's learn the word wrap feature of WordPad. Word wrap is used to arrange the text on your screen. The default option is wrapped a ruler. That means, your text will wrap automatically, according to the ruler, or your page size. If you change this option to wrapped a window, then your text will get expanded to the size of your WordPad window, and you can see more contents on your screen. If you choose no wrap option, then your text will only wrap at breakpoints. As you can see that, now we only have two lines on our screen, because there were only two breaks between our paragraphs. Do note down that, wrap to window, and no wrap option are only for display purpose. That means they will not make any effect on your printouts. If you are creating a new document and want to have a printout of the same, then it is a good idea to choose wrap to ruler option, so you get the exact printout that you are seeing on your screen. We still have one more lesson of Wordpad to go, which is about keyboard shortcut keys. This video will shortly be uploaded. Till then, keep practicing and have a nice day.